That is one chunky boy. Look at the size of you. Let's see if you like your new enclosure. Big enough for that big butt of yours. I really want to see you try out those climbing frames. Those took me forever to put together. I hope you like them. We just gonna stare at it or use it? Oh, hey, you've only been in here 2 minutes and you're already pooping everywhere. Not showing that on camera. Oh, look at the size of it. What have you been eating? Pooping in this game never gets old. Hello and welcome to Planet Zoo. Today's build is a bit of an odd one. I picked up the game again this weekend after a couple weeks break due to some other work commitments, and I really didn't know what I wanted to build. Sometimes I feel like I've got 100 ideas in my head, but I'm guilty of thinking too much and not just playing enough. So last night, I opened up a new sandbox save and told myself to just have fun. Just build whatever you can think of, doesn't matter if it's good, it's bad. Just start putting shapes together and see what happens. Well, in doing that, I ended up with this big window and a doorway in between it. When I built this, I had no idea what to use for, I just thought it looked pretty. So I think I started to look at whether to make it into an entrance, and I was looking at some of the information boxes and some of the food stalls, and I did like a little two-story inside building complex, but it looked absolutely rubbish, so that went in the bin. My next idea was to make this into a giraffe house, and I think I've actually got a giraffe in my inventory now because I put one in the game to see how tall they were to see if it would fit. It turns out you could actually stack about 5 giraffes in this building head to toe, so it's way too big just to use it for a giraffe house. It's at that point I remembered that some of the zoos that I've visited recently, they have like monkey enclosures that are like monkey houses, so they have a bit of inside space and a bit of outside space, but those buildings are usually quite tall because they have the climbing equipment inside and the monkeys like to climb quite high, so it has to be a tall building. And I thought, well, this might look a little bit fancy for a monkey house, but I'm quite happy doing that. And you know what? I think it looks pretty good. I always have in the back of my mind that I can't be too fancy because zoos aren't traditionally fancy, but I might be selling myself a little short here because I think some zoos are up in the games in the architectural stakes. I mean, of course, I've been doing a lot of research whilst I've been looking to build habitats in Planet Zoo from real life, and some of the architectural drawings that zoos have released are very, very impressive. So I had my mind set on making this building into a monkey enclosure. I think it was whilst I was starting to put the rock formations around the back, I realised that this was still a really massive building, and this being one enclosure just felt like such a waste. And I thought, hang on, I can split this up quite easily and make this into two enclosures. It took a little bit of fiddling with the fencing. Aside from that, it worked perfectly well. So I think I'll drop out of the speed build and just give you a tour of the completed habitats. All right, so this is the Great Ape building with those huge big windows I started off with. So I decided to go with gorillas and orangutans for the animals in here, since they're closely related and they seem to get on quite well. Okay, so inside, I've got a bit of a garden going on here. These are all plants from the animal's biome, so they do fit in quite well. I've been to some zoos that go all out with the corridor decoration in these sort of buildings. So like the walls are made to look like forest and there might be plastic plants and vines hanging around everywhere. But I thought that was maybe going a bit overboard for this build. So I've stuck with the plants at the front where the glass is. Now, as you can see here, there's some ramps that take you up to the viewing platform. However, I've also got a lower ground viewing area behind here. Now, you're not really guaranteed a good view from down here, since, well, the apes will be doing a lot of climbing, you're gonna have a better view up top. But the ground floor viewing area is there for those who just can't be bothered to go up there, and you can still see some of the indoor action from here. And, well, you can get your photo taken with the gorilla statues, I guess. Right, so let's go upstairs. You'll notice instead of stairs, these are old ramps to aid accessibility. I also added a bit of colour to the walls here. I seem to always go with green or white for the walls, and I think that's a subconscious thing from the Planet Zoo colour being green. Going up the ramps gives you a great view from the windows here. So up here is the main viewing platform, and you get a fantastic view of them doing their climbing stuff when they're indoors. I love how the windows here give that little bit of extra light without interfering with the monkey's business. If I pop through the window here, You can see how I've got the barrier to slope upwards to match that of the slope ceiling. You can adjust the height of the barriers at the post, so that was actually quite easy to do to make it match. So that splits the enclosures into two quite nicely. Right, so from the upper viewing deck, there's two exits. One can take you past the gorilla's outdoor enclosure, the other one is the orangutan's. There's nothing stopping people looking at them both though. I think we'll have a look down at the gorillas. So here, guests are well away enough that they shouldn't be bothering the gorillas from here, but it's still a great view. Now, this fencing is climbable, but I haven't seen them attempt it yet. I just don't think they're agile enough to climb over the rocks. Although I have got this protective anti-climb post at the top as well, just in case. So yeah, these guys are enjoying themselves in here, releasing their bowels at an alarming rate as well. Anyway, let's carry on. The other side of this is the downward exit ramp that takes you back round to the front. I've set down a little food area out here as well and some landscaping. The sort of patterns you can make with the stone pieces are a nice easy way to make landscaping look a little more interesting. I've got a similar one on the other side that leads down from the orangutan enclosure. Let's actually take a look at those guys since we're here. Aren't they cute? You know, to be honest, I'm not actually a huge fan of primates. I don't get the appeal. The monkey kind, not the human kind. I do like other humans. Anyway, yeah, so that's my ape enclosure. It is available on the Steam Workshop if you want to use this for yourself. Just bear in mind that the pathing is a bit fiddly since it's using a grid pattern for the inside, and this bit here on the outside, you just have to follow the wood walls here on the lowest incline and the path will follow that. But I do appreciate pathing is a nightmare for everyone. I do really wish there was an easier way to deal with it. Oh, another thing about the workshop. This has been saved as a habitat to keep all the terrain settings. To work as the two habitat setup, when the blueprint is placed in game, you need to highlight hidden barriers in the path setting, then delete the null barrier I've put around this whole build. That'll then let you put the normal gates back into the two enclosure setup here. If you do have problems, let me know in the comments and I can help you through that. Anyway, I hope you like the build. If you do like it, you can actually also tell me that in the comments. I like hearing people's opinion either way. So, until next time, thank you for watching. Bye for now.